Hello, welcome back for another Knights and Merchants Shoutcast. This is yet another matchup, 1v1, Mexican T versus Koczis. You can see the match is already well underway. The opening will be very similar to that which was played last time. Only a couple of things worth mentioning that will be different, and that is the locations the players are playing on are, of course, not that in which my most recent video was. You can see Koczis is playing down here, and Mex T is up here. This is location 1, I believe, and this one is... well, I can't say I remember the number. Anyhoot, why is this significant? Well, this location is deemed to be the more difficult or not as strong as many of the others, so Koczis already off the bat could be considered to be at a disadvantage. However, an advantage he does have is this fish here is technically supposed to be split among these two locations. Last time Mexi had the additional fish well into the game, this time Koczis will have the extra fish. And there's additional fish up here if he so chooses to take it. His fisherman will be alive and just eating food unnecessarily after all this runs out, so he has no reason not to build up here if he has time to do so. Mexi, on the other hand, has even better advantages in that this location is has technically a whole extra mountain of gold, though they probably have a gentleman's agreement for him not to take it, since this gold is technically supposed to be shared by the teammate down here. The location here would not normally have access to this extra gold. And to go along with that, this extra coal, and technically even this right here, although that's pretty far away and a bit more difficult to take. Anyway, I digress. The whole point being is that Mexi technically has two locations worth of coal and gold. If he decides to go for those in the long game, he will have no problem having a better economy than Koczis. Nothing special so far. We see Mexi has a moderate to low amount of farms at 3, Koczis having a bit more normal amount for this point in the game. Does Koczis have, okay, yes, he also has a swine farm up and a fisher, and I guess both players looking pretty neck and neck. Of course, Koczis having the additional farm being the only difference. It's worth saying that Mexi's iron production is well ahead of Koczis. In fact, I would say miles ahead, I guess, in this speed. I did not even notice that Koczis doesn't even have a weapons maker up yet, which is really unusual for this point in the game. By 30 minutes, you really want to be making weapons if you hope to have a decent amount of iron troops. It's worth pointing out that both players are electing to make crossbows right off the bat, so we will see a revenge of the ballista, and we'll see who can outmaneuver and push with their crossbows better. I like this wood setup by Koczis, everything in the one spot. Is it more efficient that way? Probably not necessarily, but it is nice when you can have all the your wood production working nicely in one spot. I will point out that wood cutters technically work a bit more efficiently when they have a mountain above them. That might seem strange, but that's just the way the numbers work out. If the woodcutters have the mountains above them, they'll have a slightly higher output, and as such, these woodcutters have the potential to be quite efficient. Obviously, below is where you want them planting, and right here, this is not super optimal. But a little fun fact, and that's because it takes a little bit longer for them to walk above the building than it takes for them to walk below. Don't worry about that too much, because in most situations it's not practical, but it is worth keeping in mind that just because they seem to have a lot of area they can't plant in, technically these guys right here are just happy not worrying about planting above their location. Above the location of their house. And alrighty, we have Mexi electing to cut the trees away and not to replant them up here. I prefer, personally, to keep those trees the entire game, because I don't like destroying woodcutters if I don't need to, and I don't feel it's needed up here, especially when you're playing 1v1. Plenty of room down here. That saying, though, you'll need to cut down trees and destroy the woodcutter in at least one place, because I do destroy this woodcutter down here when I play 1v1. So, excuse me. So even though I just got done saying that I like to keep the trees up and running and not destroy them if I don't need to, I do destroy the one down here. So, put your money where your mouth is, I guess. Does Koczis have his barracks up? Yes, he does. Very good. And, funny enough, he seems to be ahead in the iron production, but only because, okay, Mexi did make some swords as well, which is good. Koczis will have to switch into those as well if he hopes to get some knights out, which he does plan on doing. And we'll see if Koczis' economy is looking similar to last time. Yes, it is. 8 farms, probably going for a 9th, and then Mexi also 9 farms. At 4 sawmills right now, I trust that he will make an additional one, as he normally does in a 1-vs-1 matchup, and Koczis might sit pretty at 4 for the entire game. Now, I do see Koczis is making a market, which is very nice. I'm glad to see it. Hopefully, he will be able to use that efficiently to keep his economy rolling late into the game, if the game so reaches that point. Koczis is making an additional fisherman up here, and I do not believe that this guy is done fishing yet. And no, I see plenty of fish swimming around in the pond, and that means that he will have 2 fishermen running. That'll keep his food running comfortably. He will not need to worry about making, any bakeries at all, I figure. Whereas Mexi is sitting pretty on 1 bakery right now. Obviously, bread is the more sustainable, but you don't want to be wasting your corn on bread if it's not needed. We'll pause the game at 60 minutes and compare the economies at the hour. And just so I don't accidentally skip by it, I will go ahead and slow it down. Being extra careful here. Very good. So, we have Koczis at exactly 8 horses. It looks like he managed that economy, or the iron, perfectly. It worked out well for him. And plenty of axe fighters. Mexi's sitting at only 12 axe fighters himself, though he is making additional shields, no doubt. Does he have... Okay, he's not making any here. And well, I don't know. Anyway, I'm sure he knows what he's doing with that. He's a bit short on shields, but... Well, he doesn't have very many bows either, so a lot of this leather armor is going to just sit in the barracks for a few minutes, though he's got plenty of other weapons to man his own mere 63 recruits with, and don't take that for a small amount of recruits. It is difficult to get more than 70. Koczis having 70 himself. And he did make some lance carriers, as well as Mexi did. If I had to pick an army, I would pick Koczis. Normally, I would always pick the one with... Well, my goodness, Mexi only does have 1 horse. So yeah, I definitely like Koczis' army a little bit more here. He doesn't have the pikemen, but his extra horses and axe fighters will do a good job making his melee feel a little bit more buffy than Mexi's. Did Mexi make a stable? Yes, he did. It must have been late. I don't know. Does he have more leather armor? No, Koczis has more leather armor. Anyway, I could stare back at these numbers back and forth for an hour. You can make your own conclusions on which army you think is stronger. They're both pretty neck and neck, so no need to worry too much about that. What's important is what you can do with that army. We're not going to worry too much about the scouting because... Can't imagine anything too crazy or interesting will happen. So we'll speed it up a little bit more to get the battlefield underway, and we'll compare the economies. You can look through these really quickly. You can see, yes, right as I was looking at it, he went ahead and started making his 5th sawmill. Is he actually making it, or is it... Yeah, okay, he's actually making it. It's not just a placeholder. And Koczis is still at 4, and I don't expect that to change. So, excuse me. We'll see if Mexi's economy can. And he did make a third metallurgist. So I was just about to say, even though he's making a fifth sawmill, I doubt he's making a third metallurgist. But he is indeed, and that will help him to keep plenty of recruits and an access even. So he'll have absolutely no trouble with recruit production, so long as these buildings remain fairly stocked full on coal. But anyway, on to the battle. We can see the armies are lined up, and hopefully it's a good fight. Hopefully nothing too silly happens. You want to be very careful dancing with the knights. The so-called dancing is a really good way to absorb bow fire, but crossbows, they can kill knights in a hurry. If you don't already know it, crossbowmen shoot slower than bowmen, but have additional pierce attack against shields. The more proper way to say it is that shields offer less defense against crossbowmen, as they do to bowmen. And that's not just because crossbowmen have a higher attack. No, that double dips on the advantage. Crossbowmen have a higher attack and pierce shields better. So, you'll notice your knights dying much faster to bowmen. A single volley could wreck your line of sword fighters, for example. And it's something to definitely keep an eye out for. There are other advantages of crossbowmen, but they are considered weaker than bows, and that's for the chief reason that sword fighters are just so strong, and knights too. Okay, we have a cot. Here I am rambling, and I really didn't expect that catch to happen, and I don't think Mexi did either. Maybe he was focusing on moving other troops elsewhere, or his eyes were otherwise not engaged there. Or perhaps even more likely is he gave them an order to move to a certain spot, or it was delayed, or they just did not take the route he intended. But anyway, he will lose all his knights here, but his crossbowmen are in a fair position. Not all of them are shooting, but that he might get a few kills off himself. Probably hoping to catch the rest of the pikes there, but he was not able to do so. And since Mexi had nothing in front of his crossbows to distract the fire of the crossbowmen here, of his enemy crossbowmen, he lost a few range units himself. Very surprised that these pikes haven't been shredded apart by the... Well, there's one kill anyway. But it doesn't take very many shots for a crossbowman to kill pikemen. We'll just leave it at that. I do want to doubly make a point that crossbowmen won't deal more damage to a sword fighter than they will to a pikeman. No, their bonus only reduces the effectiveness of shields. It does not give a bonus against shields. There shouldn't have been any confusion there, but just in case, we'll clear that up. If any of the viewers are wondering why you see builders running down here, it's because after the 60 minutes, it's too difficult to focus heavily on building, and you won't need as many builders as you do throughout the hour. So you can send some off to their death, and you won't need to worry about feeding them. Okay, will we have a catch here? Probably, possibly not. Okay. Oh, it was very close right there, and I think that definitely would have been a good catch for Mexi, but hard to say. He probably would have lost all his pikemen, but would have killed off all of these knights and some crossbowmen as well. Mexi's having a hard time maneuvering because of his lack of horses, and Koczis is probably going to take advantage of that very soon. He is doing flanking as much he can with all these axe fighters he has. And I want to make a note that in front of his crossbowmen, he does not have very many soldiers guarding them. And I think that can be another advantage of crossbowmen, in that it's harder to make a push on them because they're so strong in that they're... And they have additional armor too, and that does count for something. In this tight passage, they're relatively safe, even with just these knights and small group of lance carriers protecting them. I believe Koczis has the same opinion, and that's why he's sending all of the soldiers around to do some kind of pincer attack on Mexi. And will it work? We will see. There will be an engagement here very soon, likely. Mexi doesn't have much room left to run, and unless Koczis... Okay, here we go. Definitely going to be a catch here. We'll move it a few ticks forward to make sure. Okay, we're definitely catching here then. Excuse me. Let's look at this and try to see if we can figure out what's going to happen. Koczis did bring his extra crossbowman over. Do we have any reinforcements coming from him? No. So we will only see reinforcements from Mexi likely, and yes, indeed. The reason I said only from him is because his barracks is much closer. Probably half the distance, and he does already have soldiers coming. Doesn't look like very much. About 10 soldiers, 5 axe fighters, and ranged units respectively. Mexi's ranged is definitely in the better position, despite him being the final pusher and aggravator on this attack. But Koczis is in position to do his pincer attack that we spoke of earlier, and we will see if he is able to execute that. What will Koczis do with these knights here? If I were him, I would try to, I would move them around. They're not going to do much right here. Not as much as they could if they were distracting more soldiers in the back. Okay, they got caught. Perhaps he was trying to move them around, but they did get caught there. And these guys here, they're not doing anything. Okay, there we go. They're being sent in. You can already see that these crossbowmen are being attacked. Now, I do want to point out that this sword fighter has, from what I have watched, maybe he's attacked even more than that. He's taken 3 swings head-on to this crossbowman. And the crossbowman is still alive. During that time, he's probably got 2 or 3 shots off himself. And that difference is huge when you compare it to a bowman who likely would have died on the first hit. And that is a value people probably should consider when they're thinking crossbowmen. The fact that they're able to survive that many hits from a sword fighter head-to-head, that's got to count for something. So we will see if these crossbowmen can hold. They're going to need to step back really soon because they're... Still, these crossbowmen are holding. And these guys in the back are... I'll pause it again. These crossbowmen in the back are likely shooting at these guys here, and these ones in the front are killing the range. So even though he's losing crossbowmen here, so is Mexi. So this isn't actually really bad for Koczis at all. And there it is. That entire group that was trying to kill these crossbowmen, gone. If these were bowmen, these guys here would have just shredded all the way through them. Koczis would have had to withdraw even, if that was the case. But they were crossbowmen, and they stood their ground and endured. And speaking of crossbowmen doing the work, Mexi's crossbowmen were able to shred apart Koczis last night. These axe fighters won't stand a chance against this group of range, so Koczis needs to withdraw. Mexi unwilling to risk his knight's life there to catch these axe fighters. And Koczis doing a pretty good job avoiding shots here and keeping his axe fighters relatively safe. He's going to try to get into this choke point likely, and Mexi's going to have to think twice about engaging here. Indeed, he realizes there's not much damage he can do here. No, not much point in attacking these axe fighters at this time. So he will, well, I guess he is kind of still pushing. Really didn't expect that, but... Nevertheless, okay. Koczis feeling a little brave, perhaps because he was able to get a knight around behind, but knight in the back is not going to do a whole lot if he's catching pikemen. I guess it's worth saying he caught this group here and it distracted them. Reinforcements from Koczis are here, but... didn't look like a good fight for Koczis. He killed some, but lost more. And you see that one volley from those crossbowmen were able to take out that knight. Very strong. Seems like players are content to look at their bases for now. Is Koczis using his market? No, he hasn't used it yet. And neither is Mexi, but perhaps both players. Well, Koczis could trade some of these axes away for, and yes he is. He's trading some axes away for gold. it'll do much better. Those axes will do better as gold chests than sitting around as decorations in the barracks. So I like that from him. And he did end up building a bakery, which is good. That with the fish, it'll keep him keep his people very satisfied, very well fed. Mexi's not looking too bad either on the food side. And I wonder why that is. Why is Mexi doing? I guess they're both doing just fine. Mexi does have a vineyard. Two vineyards. So that's probably pretty close to one fisherman. So the fish not looking like it's playing out to be too much an advantage for Koczis. This coal, which Mexi is now starting to exploit, that's going to be a much nicer boost. Okay, Koczis doing some sneaky tactics, and I meant to pause it. I wanted to point out yet another nice caveat of the crossbowmen there. Koczis would have swept in and probably killed three or four bows and got out of there safely, but he got caught head-to-head on a crossbowman, and even after four or five swings, wasn't able to kill it. And thus, Mexi lost two crossbows and one bowman and killed one knight. At the end of the day, pretty close to an even exchange. And in a scenario like this, that was Koczis, one of his last knights here. Definitely the advantage for Mexi there. Something to consider. You can't rely on the crossbows dying one hit like you can on bows, so you can't run in and do sneaky attacks with your knights as often. Both players having their range in nice positions, able to eliminate melee soldiers very quickly. Koczis still having more production than he can handle. Perhaps it's time for him to make a third metallurgist, and in fact, I think he did. So hopefully that catches up too, but I guess his coal is not looking so pretty right now. Okay, for some reason, Mexi feels like he can really push on this, but really don't know. He is doing damage. But these lance carriers, they'll just disappear. Koczis even has additional soldiers here, and he's doing a storm and having his knight flank around behind, and this will get some damage done. Well, hopefully. Okay, Mexi is withdrawing, as he should. The threat is just too much from Koczis here. More storms from Koczis. He is pushing hard and fast on these crossbowmen, but falling back for now. The armies are looking somewhat even. Koczis does have doubled crossbows. Mexi's making his numbers look a little bit better by the little bowman here, but don't forget Koczis also has some crossbowmen down here. So yes, Koczis still has many of his crossbowmen left. If he can feed them, then they'll serve him well in the future. And oh, lots of reinforcements coming for Koczis here. Mexi also enjoying some supplements to his regiments. I think it's really time for Koczis to trade some wooden shields to Cole, because he's really, I mean, see, everything is, well, that was a really bad example. Lots of coal could be used right now. And you see, he is content to take a break for now and feed his men. You can see it does cost him a bit because his inn is completely empty at the moment. So some of his citizens probably will feel the hunger for a little bit, but won't be too much of an issue, I'm sure. I say that, and then I see his stable master's hungry. That'll make it difficult to get knights out for a little bit. Okay, why is Mexi running over here? Maybe he was trying to kill off some serfs with food. Because he already sees over there. Okay, the coach is feeling like the battlefield up here is a bit better. Though he's probably got his eyes on this single tower up here that... Does he see? Okay, he doesn't know if there's more towers up there. So he'll probably be careful around it. Or, though saying that, I see he is storming in, and this is, well, he does have himself trapped now. And if, Mexi can make, well, Koczis needs to not just sit. It is nice if he can just sit on Mexi's farms. That'll ravage his economy, but if Mexi brings more reinforcements, he'll be quite stuck here. And these crossbowmen are being chased away by these lance carriers. Okay, if I were Mexi, I would have probably just kept pushing on these guys, but... Because now they're going to harass his flank, but he's really worried about his farms, and this is looking very bad. Mexi's going to lose a lot of serfs here. He's at 88 right now. Probably lost all of his farmers. He's down to 5. If Mexi can get a good fight here and kill off Koczis' entire army and push hard and fast, Koczis's got a lot of towers, so he's not going to be able to just run those down. Mexi needs a good fight here. He's destroying his farms to help his soldiers get to better positions. Lost both his knights over here, and it's starting to look not so great. He destroyed this farm, but this one here is doing a good job of blocking the soldiers off now. Coach is doing what I like to see and see, having him split his knight here. This one will run down and get some kills in, as long as the serfs don't get that tower and the stones it needs to throw. Okay, he's gonna lose this knight. And, I'm having a hard time telling the difference between these colors, but... Koczis did a confident job of cleaning up Mexi's army, and there is more coming from behind. And that is, that's a good game. We speed it up the rest of the way, but... With, Mexi's economy this bad, and he lost so much army in that fight, so there's no way he'll be able to come back from that. He's only down to 66 serfs. He's lost most of his farmers, all of his corn farmers for that matter, only his vineyards are back. And a crap storm from Koczis, plenty of militia. I guess he got the gold he needed to, he could make even more yet. At this time, these militia are pretty nice for storming the space. So there we go, we'll call it there. Good game. good job from Koczis. Was able to get his revenge, finally, from the Ballista user, Mexi. And there we go. There you have it. Until the very end there, it looked like Mexi had the better economy. Mexican had his base invaded for the last 10 minutes of that game, and yet still had just as many soldiers produced as Koczis. A nice boom from Mexi here, but he didn't take the right fight, it seemed. And, well, in the end there, the pressure on Mexi's base was too much, and he had to do a quick engagement, just wasn't able to get the kills in to compensate for what happened to his base. In fact, he didn't push Koczis out at all, so very good observation from Koczis, seeing that he had the potential to just run into Mexi's base. I like that. I like aggressive play like that. It's always interesting to see in a campy game such as Knights and Merchants. Oh, you can see that fish. Far more than double the fish produced, and that reflected in the food graph, not by much. I guess the lesson learned is not to underestimate those wine barrels, as they did a good job helping him keep up. Ah, of course, Mexi had the bakery much sooner than Koczis. I forgot about that. Did they produce crossbows to the very end, I wonder? Okay, they were. To the very end. A limited amount of pikes made from Koczis, or Mexi, then he stopped. Alright, so always fun games between these two, one versus one. Enjoy watching them. And I hope you enjoyed too, and we'll see you back next time for another Knights and Merchants Showcast.